Andy Bowyer, Race Day Live, presented by AMSOIL. This is this week's Toyota Tailgate Talk with Justin Barcia. Justin, this is the deepest field we think we've ever seen in history. What are your thoughts on that?
I say that every year, but yeah, it is a very deep. You know, in the press conference, there was 13-plus guys up there that can potentially win a main event. So it's, you know, as a rider, it's like, wow, this is crazy. But, you know, we put in the preparation and the work, and we know where we belong. But it's definitely going to be a tough season, one of the harder ones of the year. So, yeah, I'm excited, though. I'm ready to go race, and it's nice to be out here and see all our friends and whatnot. Yeah.
Well, you know what it's like at the front of the pack. At the end of the summer last year, you were beating Ryan Dungey straight up in motos. That had to give you a special confidence. And how do you find that confidence and bring it over here to Supercross?
Yeah, for sure. That's definitely a confidence booster, running with Dungey at the end of the season and outdoors. Just, you know, it took a while for us to get comfortable and good on the bike, but we have it now. And, you know, we're just going to have to go out there, get good starts, and put ourselves in the right position. That's, you know, pretty much it's up to me now. Yeah. You know, the team did the work. I did the off-season work. Now you just got to go out there and make it happen. And I know what I need to do. Now I just need to execute.
We talk about that off-season work. What do we got going on here? We lose a tire? What happened? How'd we go down?
Well, I've been great on my dirt bike. I actually tanked my mountain bike, slid down the hill a little, got some road rush. So, yeah, you know, us motocrossers, we get a little in our cross training, you know, going fast. You think you're a bad dude on a mountain bike, and then you slide out. So, yeah, you know, just keeping it fun and having a good time.
Speaking of that, talk about your team. You know, riding for JGR, you know, NASCAR stuff, Super Bowl victories. You guys have a lot of sponsors, like Wiener Schnitzel's back on board this year. They got a Toyota truck. How much fun is it working with this organization?
Oh, it's awesome, and that's why I just resigned for another 2 years. It's very special to be on a team like this. It's very family oriented, and I'm super happy and comfortable here, and I'm glad to be a part of the family because it is like a family to me, and I get along with everyone really well, and there's no bad apples, really. It's a whole bunch of good dudes, and we've been having a good time and working super hard, and it's nice to be on a team, and I know I'm going to be here for another 2 years, so it makes me happy, that's for sure.
Let's talk about the one thing, the biggest part of the race that we've talked about for years is the starts. And throughout your career, you always got good starts. In the 250 class, you got good starts. You kind of got away from that last year. How are you going to find those starts again that are Justin Barcia trademark?
Yeah, for sure. 250 days, I was whole shot king. Got a ton of starts. And then the 450, it just, man, it's just so much power. And to learn how to control it. And I had to pretty much change, you know, a lot of my technique and learn how to, you know, start on this thing better. And, you know, obviously towards the end of outdoors, it showed that I figured out my starts again. And just we're going to bring that into Supercross. You know, it's all about controlling that power. There's so much power. And if you get a wheelie going or whatnot, you know, you can lose a start just like that. So we've definitely figured it out, and we're hoping to bring that into Supercross.
17 races and 18 weekends. Put your head around that. Are you prepared?
Oh, I mean, we're definitely prepared. You know, we've put in the work and the time. I know, you know, there's no slacking for me in the off season. I put in my time and work, and, you know, we're ready to go. But it is a long series. You know, obviously the goal is to try to win a championship. But for me, the biggest thing is being consistent and not taking myself out of the series right in the beginning. You know, I've had good races in Supercross. I've won a Supercross race, but I just, you know, I've never been perfectly consistent. Last year in outdoors, I showed that I was more consistent, more comfortable, had a couple bad races, but still was there most of the time. So I think just maturing and having a few years under my belt will definitely be good.
Speaking of years under your belt, one of your biggest fans you've always had is David Iser. He says, fear the beard. What's up with that? Is it time to fear the beard 2016?
Well, the beard's here in full force, so I hope everyone's fearing the beard. Yeah, it's just all for fun, though. You know, my mechanic Ben's got a huge beard, and I'm trying to follow in his footsteps, I guess you could say, but I got a long way to go.
Well, cool. Thanks for talking to us. Good luck.
Thanks
man.
Thanks so much. I appreciate it.